So today, in this session, we are going to study about Mendel's law of independent assortment. So now, this is a law which states that when two pairs of traits are combined in a hybrid, segregation of one pair of character is independent of the other pair of character at the time of gamete formation. So this is a law statement. So it means that when two pairs of traits are combined, so two pairs of traits means two characters. When two characters are seen in a hybrid, okay, when they are seen in a hybrid, we can say that they segregate. In a hybrid, two pairs of characters, when they are present, they are going to separate each other independently. So this statement can be understood by seeing dihybrid cross. So you all know that dihybrid cross is nothing but when a cross is made between two organisms which differ in two contrasting characters is called dihybrid cross. So because we are taking two characters, it is also called as inheritance of two genes. So each character is mainly done by one gene. So it is also called as inheritance of two genes. Now Mendel, as we know that, to explain this, so Mendel did an experiment by taking pea plants. So now, as you can consider here, this is a plant, that is pea plant, which produces seeds which are round in shape and yellow in color. So this is a pea plant. It is producing the seeds. So imagine these are the seeds. So in this plant, this is a plant, it is producing round seeds. It produces round seeds. So round seed is nothing but one character which tells us shape of the seed. It gives a character called shape of the seed. Shape of the seed is round, and color of the seed, if you see the color of it, it will be yellow in color. So it is yellow. So another character here is the color of the seed. So here we are considering two characters, that is shape of the seed and color of the seed. So this is a plant which is having round shape seed and yellow in color. And now this is a plant which is having the seeds. It is having the seeds which are wrinkled. So in the beginning only we have studied that contrasting characters, round and wrinkled. Wrinkled means we know it, the seed will be like this. So this is called wrinkled seeds. Okay, it is a wrinkled seeds. So this is a plant which produces wrinkled seeds. The shape of the seed is wrinkled and color of the seed is green. So this we will understand by seeing the schematic representation. So Mendel selected two plants which differ in two characters, that is nothing but the color of the seed and shape of the seed. Now in this case we can see here the parents. So here in the dihybrid cross, parents, we have the Mendel has selected as homozygous round yellow. So pure round yellow producing plant and homozygous wrinkled green. So for this we know the genotype. So let us write the genotype for this. The genotype for this is, see, for round you have to write capital R. Capital R is the gene for round. And for yellow it is capital Y, capital Y. So for every character, so we know that alleles are present and this is dominant, and that is why we are writing capital letters. Now coming to here, homozygous wrinkled. So round and wrinkled is opposite. So for wrinkled we are writing small r, small r. So round, capital R, capital R. For wrinkled, it is small r, small r. And yellow and green, both colors are opposite to each other. Here we have used capital Y. For green, we are going to use small y, small y. So this is a genotype of the parents. Now the parents will produce gametes. So as we know that the gametes will have half of the chromosomes. Now coming to here, the gametes are nothing but, so out of 2R, half of the chromosomes will come. So we are writing capital R, only one R. So out of 2Y, gametes will have only half. So you are writing only 1Y. So capital Y. So this is a gamete, that is why we are rounding up. Now coming to here also, out of 2 small r's, so the gamete will have only 1 R, and out of 2Y, only 1 small y it will be having. As you know very well that, so if this is a parent, so male parent means it is producing pollen grain. Pollen grain is haploid in nature. If you consider this as a female parent, it is producing the egg, which is haploid in nature. Now the fertilization will take place. So these two gametes will undergo fertilization. So when this fertilization takes place, it is nothing but the F1 generation. So we are writing here the F1 generation. In the first generation, so syngamy or fertilization, so here we can find that the genes are capital R, small r, capital Y and small y. Always we have to write dominant gene first, and then because it is for shape, this is also for shape of the seed, we are writing next to it. So these two represents shape of the seed, these two represent color of the seed, Y represents color of the seed, and first we have to write dominant gene. So dominant here is capital Y and recessive one is small y. So in F1 generation, this is a F1 generation, all plants were heterozygous. So they were, all plants obtained were heterozygous, round yellow. So now if you see here, out of these two, R is dominant. Capital R is dominant. R represents round. The shape of the seed was round. And now coming to here, color. When you see the color, capital Y is dominant and always the dominant character is seen. So Y means here yellow, round yellow. So now here, so when a cross is made between these two parents, all the seeds, whatever they collected and when they sow it, all plants produced was producing the seeds which were round yellow. Now the question is, what happened for the genes for this wrinkled green? So now what happened? They started doing, Mendel started doing selfing. Mendel started doing selfing. So selfing means, you know, F1 into F1. So here F1 into F1 means it is nothing but capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, into, you are having again capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So this is nothing but F1 hybrid. So this is a F1 hybrid, F1 generation it is, F1 hybrid it is. So this again, it has been selfing. Same genes will be repeated. That is why you are writing these two similar. Now, imagine now this, these two are the parents. So now it is going to produce gamete. So this is going to produce gametes. Okay. So this gametes are very, very important. They will ask in the exam. The gametes of round yellow and wrinkled seed. So here we know that we can write here the gametes as, see this R and this Y. So the gametes may be four types you are going to get. Let us see all the four types here. So capital R, capital Y. And now this R, if this is fusing with this. So fusing in a sense, the gamete formation. When the gametes are forming, here you can see capital R, capital Y is formed. Then if this R and this Y, then here you are going to get small r, capital Y gamete. And if this small r and this Y fuses, then the gametes produce, because the genes, understand here, the genes are four are there. The combination of this, if you see, you will get capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, small y, or you will get small r, small y. So these are the four gametes we are going to get from this parent. So this is a parent, means imagine this is a parent, now male parent. From this we are going to get four pollen grains. Four pollen grains, they are having different genes in it. Now coming to here, if this is a female one, so in this also we are going to get the eggs. Imagine now the genes present in the egg will be of four different kinds. So this and this, okay, capital R, small y, or you can find capital R, this is capital R, capital Y, here capital R, small y. Then here we can find small r, capital Y, and then this and this, that is small r, small y. These are the four gametes which are produced. So now we are going to see F2 generation. In F2 generation, what happens if this pollen grain fuses with this egg? What happens? That we are going to study. So here, as we have studied the gametes produced by the parents are four we have seen. So let us see first what are the gametes formed. We are going to write down first those gametes. Okay. So here, as in the Punnett's checkerboard, we were writing all the gametes we will write. So this is nothing but the male and female. We got four gametes we have got. We know that the four gametes are nothing but the capital R and capital Y and capital R, small y. Then we have got small r, capital Y, and then small r, small y. These are the four gametes or pollen grains, whatever I have told. And this side also same, we have got capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, and then small r, capital Y, small r, small y. So these are the four gametes we have got, different gametes from pollen grains. And if you imagine from the female plant also, we have got all these four gametes. So now we are going to fuse. So imagine now this fuses with this. So we are going to get capital R, capital R. We get, imagine now this and this I am doing. So capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. If this egg fuses with this pollen grain, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y we are getting. Now same with this. So this is fusing with this. Now you will get capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. In the same way you are doing for this too. So you are taking here RY, you are taking the first one from here, and then column, third column you are seeing. So here you can find, so this is a fourth column. So you are getting capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Last one we will see, capital R, capital Y, and here you are having small r, small y. So capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. As I told you, always you have to write together shape of the seal, color of the seal. Next we go for second one. From the this you can find here, this is fused with this. So here we can find capital R, capital R, and here first we have to write dominant gene and here small y. Now this and this, we are taking this, okay? So capital R, capital R, small y, small y. Again this with here. So when this pollen grain fuses with that, we are getting capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Always see to that here also you are writing dominant gene first and then always you have to write recessive gene. So from this two you can write capital R, small r, small y, small y. So next you can go for the here. From here if you count, it is nothing but the third one, small r, capital Y is there. So you just cross with the first one here. So you will get capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. And this with the second one, if you do, when this crosses, you are getting capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Same way, this with this you are doing, so that small r, capital Y you get. So now this is fused with this, you are going to get small r, capital Y, small y. So last one in the row, last one R Y, and the column first one, if you see, you are going to get capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. And now this with the second one column, if you see, then capital R, small r, small y, small y. So see this last row, that is R Y, and here also R Y. You have in both the cases small r you have, but one capital Y, small y. And the last one R Y, small y, here also small y. Here you are writing small r, small y, small y. So after this, let us see what are the genotypes of this. So if you see here, you can find here both are dominant RR. So it is round. Okay, it is round. So here it is dominant yellow. Y is dominant. Y codes for yellow. So round yellow. So it is round yellow. Now if you check here, here also both are dominant. You are writing it as round. And if you see here, one is dominant, one is recessive, but dominant one is seen in the what we can say phenotypically. Hence here also round yellow. Now coming to here, see here also dominant R is there, hence round, and both are yellow only we are writing. Here again heterozygous round is there, so the genotype will be round, and here again yellow. So we have got in the first row all are round yellow. Let us see here. So here also it is round. Now when you see these two things, again Y is dominant. Y represents yellow. So we are writing yellow. Now coming to here, so it is round, whereas it is of small letter YY is present. Okay, small letter YY is present. So it is because both are RR, it represents round. But small y represents green. Okay, it is round green. So let us see the next one. So it is again RR is there. So it is round. Okay, so here it is round. And then you are having Y. Okay. So capital Y is present, so it is round yellow. It is round yellow. So it is round and this is yellow. Round yellow. Now coming to here, you can see capital R, small r is present round, but small y will represent green. So small y will represent green. Okay. So let us see. So round. So here it is round and then green. Round green. So the next one, if you see, it is capital R, small r is there. Again, it is nothing but round yellow. We get here round and this is yellow. Round yellow. And here also it is round and then again here yellow. Round yellow. So now coming to here, small r, small r. Small r, small r will represent wrinkled. Small r will represent wrinkled one. Okay. So this is wrinkled yellow. So now it is wrinkled yellow. It is wrinkled yellow. Okay. So next one, here we can find small r, capital Y, small y. Again here also it is wrinkled yellow. Small r represents wrinkled and capital Y represents yellow. So though I told you both are there, because capital Y is dominant, we have to write yellow. Now coming to here, so both R is present, but we know very well that capital R is dominant here and capital Y is dominant. Both represents round yellow it is. Okay. So round yellow. Now coming to here, so here round is dominant. Whereas when you see YY, small y represents green. Okay. So now here we can find that it is round green. It gives round green. Now in the next one we can find here small r is nothing but wrinkled and y is yellow. Wrinkled yellow it is. Okay. So here it is wrinkled yellow, because Y is dominant, we are writing wrinkled yellow. Now in the last column you can see small r, small y is present. So it represents, so small r means we know it is wrinkled. Okay. And then small y means green, wrinkled green. So this is what in the F2 generation, please remember that it is nothing but F2 generation. We have to write it compulsorily that it is F2 generation. So in a F2 generation, overall we are going to get 16 plants we are going to get. Out of 16 plants, if you see, we can find that round yellow are 9. So we can count here, complete this row. If you see, complete row here is round yellow. Okay, this row and this row completely it is round yellow. Let me count here the round yellows. Okay, so this is, I am putting just star mark here. So we are having upper side 4 round yellows, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 round yellow. Okay, so we will write here the G, that is first we will write phenotypic ratio. We know very well phenotype. Phenotype is nothing but outer, external appearance. So we have seen 16 plants are produced. So phenotypic ratio, let us write phenotypic ratio of this. It is nothing but externally to see there are 9 round yellow seed producing plants. So 9 are there, 9 is 2. Then now coming to round green, I will just stick here. So this is what is round green. Okay. So next, this is the round green, whichever I have written in the blue color, this is round green. So you can find 3 round green producing seed producing plants are present. So 9 is to 3 is to 3. Here you can see wrinkled yellow. So these are wrinkled yellow. So you can find here the wrinkled yellow 3 plants are present. I am just representing it with square mark. Okay, so this is what is wrinkled yellow, this is wrinkled yellow, and this is wrinkled yellow. So wrinkled yellow are three plants which produces wrinkled yellow, and only one is there, the last one, it is showing wrinkled green. So only one is wrinkled green. So phenotypic ratio is 9. Round yellow plants were 9, and 3 of them are round green producing plants were 3, and this 3 represents wrinkled yellow. It represents wrinkled yellow, and the last one is nothing but the wrinkled green. It represents wrinkled green. So if you see in this, we can make out is round yellow is like a parent. It is like a parent. First we took homozygous round yellow plant, and this one, only one is wrinkled green. It is also a parental type. But other two, if you see here, you can find that there is a mixture. So round green, wrinkled yellow. So if you find here, round is a dominant gene and green is a recessive gene, and wrinkled is a recessive gene, and yellow is a dominant gene. From this you can see here there is a recombination, there is a mixing. So from here I can tell you that round is not only joining with the round, but the round is, I mean to tell that round yellow, you had a combination round yellow, and in the F2 generation you are seeing that round is not only mixing with yellow, but it also has a capability to mix with round green. Okay, new combination you got. In the same way, wrinkled green, we took a combination, but wrinkled green, they can independently assort themselves, and wrinkled can join even with the yellow. So here this is what is called independent assortment. We took two characters, round yellow, wrinkled green, two characters we have seen, but both of them are not together always. They can get separated independently and they can join with any other factor also. So this is what is proved. So this is what is phenotypic ratio, 9:3:3:1. And let us see genotypic ratio, which is very, very important. So now coming to the genotypic ratio, the genes. Now we are finding round yellow. So all these from the Punnett square only, I have written all the genes here together. Now if you see here, we can find that the genes for round yellow, 9 were there. I have written all the 9. In this you can see capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. This is a gene where all the 4 genes are dominant. This is only one is present here. Okay, all these are round yellow only, but one is having all the 4 dominant genes. So now next you see these 2 are dominant round, and one is small, I mean capital Y, and one is small y. Like this, these 2 are present. So this combination is 2 are there. Okay, where 3 dominant genes are present. And now here also you see, here you have one capital R, one small r, and both here capital Y you have. In the same way here also it is capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Genotypic ratio means you are seeing the genes, what type of genes present there. So here also it is of 2 types are there. I mean 2 are there. 2 are there. And now coming to here, all 4 of them are similar, with capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. How many are there? 4 are there. So round yellow, if you want to write the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross, very, very important. Let me write below. So it is round yellow. If I write, it is 1:2, 2:2, 2:4 for round yellow I got. Still I have to write round green. So let us see the genotype for round green. So for round green, it is R, y. So this is only one type. And now R, y. So here also same thing. These two are same, similar. So these genes are two. So for round green, we got 1:2. Now let us see for wrinkled yellow genes. So for wrinkled yellow, r, Y. This is of only one type is there. And these two are similar, which are having r, Y. So this is two. So you are writing here also 1:2. And the last one, wrinkled green, only one plant we got. And the genotype is r, y. So it is one. So the genotypic ratio for dihybrid cross is 1:2, 2:2, 2:4:2, 1:2, 2:2, 1:2, 2:1. And very simply you can remember it easily. Like think about 12 ones are 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 ones are 12, 12 ones are 12, 1. At last you write 1. So 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, 12 ones are 12, 12 ones are 12, 1. If you write, you will get the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. So next we can see what exactly the important thing is present in independent assortment is. As we have seen that when a cross is made in the F1 generation, remember that we got only one type of plants which are producing round yellow, but they were heterozygous. And in F2 generation, we got all the plants round yellow, round green, wrinkled yellow, wrinkled green. And another most important thing is, of course, remembering the ratios. And then the law of independent assortment is applicable where exactly when they did the experiments, this ratio was coming proper only when the genes were present either in far distant from each other or they were occurring in different chromosomes. See, when you see that, you know that genes are present on the chromosomes. So many genes are present on the chromosomes. If we are selecting two different types of characters, if the genes are present far from each other and if the genes are present for different character, if the genes are present in different chromosomes, then this independent assortment is easily seen. In the next video, I am going to explain